Welcome to RaiGurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create form in Jira. Whenever we are working into any projects, that project demanded some forms to be generated. Might be for the feature request or maybe for onboarding of new resources or several other forms requirements are there. For that, Jira has provided the interface where we can build our own form where we can request the informations from the user based on the question set. This could be another issue or bug reporting form as well. So totally up to you how you want to generate, where you will get a proper interface by using the fields. You can build very attractive and nice form for your team member. So we'll see here in detail how and where we can utilize this feature of Jira. And important part, if you don't know about Jira, feel free to refer my complete Jira playlist. I've already created plenty of videos on Jira, Jira REST API, Confluence, as well as external add-ons. Feel free to refer those if you wanted to learn or enhance your skills into project management, Scrum, as well as administration. Here, whenever you want to start with forms, first you have to navigate into the projects. From the summary, you can reach out to this form sections where you will get options to create form. But important part is you need to have the proper permissions in place. If you don't have the right access or permissions, you won't be able to do it. Click on create form and this will open an interface where you can utilize existing fields to build this form for your projects. You can always customize it, share with your teams, as well as take in approval from your superiors. Now, question is how you are utilizing form in your day-to-day life or in your projects. I want you to add inside the comments how you are using forms in Jira. Next, here, let's consider we have this options where I wanted to build the form for new feature request. Here, I will just update the project name. Maybe my project is ABC, then new feature request form. So let's consider we have several team members where they are working on any product development and stakeholders wanted to add new features on regular basis. That's the reason we can create this type of form and it will automatically allocate the user where stakeholder is wanted to build these forms. Based on the priority or issue types, users can use it. Here I want the summary. That field is fine. This is the exact details what we are looking for. If we have any attachments or documents, we can attach it here. Now, if I wanted to add more fields like whom to assign, where we can add the assignee field. Labels, if you have any specific label or maybe I will add tag label. Here you can build or add your own label and this label will be added successfully. Now I wanted to also include the priority, how quickly we want to be implemented. Next, start date and due date is not required because this is a request form where stakeholder is requesting. It's totally up to the product owner or Scrum Master. If they feel this is doable, then they will do it or try to estimate it according to the project requirement. So it's very easy to develop any form and save it for your projects where your team member can utilize it on a regular basis. Now we are done. Let me preview it where I will just click on this options. Preview, it will open the complete form for me where you have the project name, new feature request, as the title. Summary, here you can add your summary. I'm just adding demo. Descriptions, whatever descriptions you want, you can add it. Assignee, you'll get all the assignee here. Label, whichever label you want, even you can create new label. Priority, we have existing priority fields, which is tagged under projects. And now we will attach any documentations which you feel required for further development. And once done, you can just click on submit and this form will be submitted successfully. If you want to submit another form, this will also give you another form. Now, at any point of time, if you want, you can just share with any of your team members, either via Slack or by selecting Teams or messages or email. Here we have options to delete the form. So you can always delete these forms whenever you think is not required for your projects. I will go back and here we'll just refresh it and we'll see this form is not added. Now this is form for me and here this is my form number 1002. Whenever I will open this form, I will get exactly same detail. And this form can be shared with any of your internal or external user. So that's how we can create a form, save all those informations and take input from the end users or stakeholders. This will always help us to take informations when we wanted to get some details, feedback, features or anything which is relevant to the projects, we can always track it. It's very easier. We have to just drag and drop the interfaces, build the form and utilize it for our team member. That's all how we can build the form in Jira. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Your feedback always matter for me. If you think this is valuable, feel free to add your feedback in comment sections. And if you wanted to learn more topics on Jira or Atlassian products, feel free to add in the comment sections. I will be happy to create videos on that topic. If you have any questions or query, reach out to me. I will always happy to help you. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in further videos.